All right, guys, so the Piggy Chapter 12 True Ending has finally been completed, and by now, a lot of people have gotten the ending, and they're getting their Mr. P skin that you get for completing the True Ending. Now, yesterday, we did a really big live stream on how to do this and complete it, but in this video, I'm going to show you really fast and really easily how you can get the True Ending by yourself and get this Mr. P skin. So, of course, real quick, if you go over to the shop right on over here at the very end, here is the Mr. P skin, so you can see I have it right there, so you know I'm not lying to you. And with that, let's go ahead and let's get started. So in order to get the True Ending, you're going to need to complete all the other chapters first and get all the other badges. And then you're going to want to go to the city map. So select city chapter 9. This works in a public server. This works in a VIP server. Works in pretty much anything. And then this is the really important part. So when you're on the voting screen, you're going to want to select player plus bot. It will not work unless you select player plus bot. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to vote for this. I'm on a VIP server by myself. And then I'm going to show you the next step. All right. So basically what you're going to have to do here is complete the entire map and then collect a secret Miss P photo, and I'll show you where that is. But there is actually something really important that you need to know. Number one, obviously there's going to be three piggies after you, and it's going to be a lot harder than normal. So that's the first thing, is that this one's going to be very, very difficult. The second thing you need to know is you cannot collect the Miss P photograph until the very end. Once you pick it up, you can't put it back down, otherwise it gets instantly deleted. So you want to make sure you complete the map fully first. So for the people unaware with this map, I'm going to use the gold key. Basically, you want to run right on over here to this second building, and this is where you're going to use the gold key at. So right on inside of this room here is where you're going to get the gold key, and then open up the safe. It's going to give you the carrot, and then with the carrot, you're going to run right on outside of here, and then you're going to give the carrot to Mr. Pony here, and he's going to activate one part of the door. Great. And then I'm going to come back on over here to the main building, and I'm just going to go ahead and collect the other key cards, because obviously we got to complete the whole map first, and that's pretty much what you got to do. So I'm going to grab the green key card. Right on over here is where you activate the green key card. I'm going to activate that. I'm going to grab the orange key card, and it looks like the bot's coming. So I'm going to have to do a little juke here and run around them like that. And then you want to once again run all the way back over to the second building and give the orange key card to, well, the orange key card room. So up these stairs here, this is where you're going to find the orange key card room. It's right on over here by the store. You're going to activate it like that. And then you're going to grab, depending on what you have in here, you're going to grab the dynamite. I'm going to get the plank first because we're going to need the plank before we get the dynamite, and then I'm going to run right back on over to this building. So there's a few objects in this map. We have the plank, which you're going to need to put on the roof. We have the dynamite, which you're going to need to get the fire extinguisher. The fire extinguisher opens up the gate at the end. You're going to need the wrench. You're going to need the gold key, and I actually think that's it, and the blue key. You're going to need that too. So I'll show you where that's at, but here's the plank right here. You're going to go ahead and plonk it down, and then we're going to go get the dynamite. Looks like Ellie's coming up, so I'm just going to run around her again like that. You can pretty easily just run around them. It's not actually too difficult. The biggest issue is when you actually have numerous ones coming after you. You don't want to get trapped in a room or anything. That'd be really bad. So now we're going to run back. We're going to get the dynamite. So the dynamite is right here in this room. It is always in that room with the orange key card. And then I'm just going to very simply run back. And then with the dynamite, we're going to go put the dynamite next to grandma's shop. So grandma's shop is right here. We're just going to go ahead. We're going to plonk it down, and then it's going to blow up the door. And then you want to be quick with this, all right? Because you don't want to get stuck in here. You want to grab the fire extinguisher, and you want to run over here to the ending gate. So right on over here is the ending gate. You're going to see there's fire on it. You're going to want to use the fire extinguisher on it like that. There we go. And then we're going to want to run back up to where we put the plank down at the top of this building. So we're just going to run right on over here to where the plank is right on here. We're going to grab the, we're going to open up the fire there like that. And then we're going to grab this. All right. This is what we need. This is the key to opening the door. We're going to use this right here like that. So now that's open. And now the last thing we need to do is get the wrench. So we need to find the blue key card. Now the blue key card is usually either in this middle alleyway here, and it's not in there, or it's in this building. So you might have to search through the rooms to find the blue key card. Normally it's upstairs. It's actually right here. Here it is. It's right there in the bottom room. So it's, sometimes it's up, sometimes it's down. But now that we have the blue key card, we're going to go and open up that. We're going to grab the red key card. It is always in that room. And then with the red key card, we're going to open up this room, and we're going to get the wrench, which is always in that little red key card room. And then we're going to run all the way back to the gate. So we're going to use the wrench on the gate. The gate's going to open. We've got the map solved, but this is the important part. Here's what you got to do now. So I recommend actually giving you a little bit of space between the monsters and you. Otherwise, this is going to be pretty difficult. So I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to let them come up here so I can actually get a little bit of space. I'm going to run down here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to run this way, and we're going to this purple car right here. Now, if you're on the player entire Plus Bot game mode, underneath this car is going to be a white piece of paper. It's going to be Miss P's photograph. Now, obviously, I already did it, so it's not there. But what you want to do is click on it one time. I'll put some footage up in the background of me doing it, but you want to click on it one time. It's going to add it to your inventory, and then you're going to want to run out of the map. So you're going to go ahead, you're going to run out of the map, and then that is going to activate the second part of the puzzle for you. So now once you're here, you can just go ahead and click skip and go back to the main menu. All right, so now that you're in the main menu, there's one more thing you have to do, and that is complete chapter 12. But there's a little thing you got to do at the end, so let me show you real quick. So I'm just going to go ahead, I'm going to select plant chapter 12, and then this one here, it doesn't matter what game mode you do, so I'm just going to choose bot because it's the easiest one for me to do. All right, so for chapter 12, you basically just want to complete the map as normal until you get to the end. So I'm going to assume you guys probably know how to complete this map. I'll show you obviously real fast if you don't. But honestly, this map's a lot easier. You grab the green key card. It's pretty obvious where the green key card goes. It goes right in there. In this building right here, you're usually going to find the blue key. The blue key goes right on over here to this door. This is where you're going to put the batteries in. I'm actually going to go in and grab a battery right there, pop it in there. And then over here is the red key. Sometimes it spawns around the area. I'm going to avoid the bot there. Obviously, there's two bots on this map. A little bit difficult. I'm going to activate the red door and I'm going to grab the battery. And the bot's on my tail, but I'm going to go ahead and put the battery in there. And that's going to activate the first pink potion that we need. So now I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to grab the pink potion from right there. And we're going to run from the bot and we're going to go put it in the middle. If you don't see the red key over there, by the way, sometimes it spawns in this area. So come back and check here. But we're going to grab the orange key card next. And we're going to do the orange key card section. This one's actually a lot easier than the green. Activate the orange key card. Now, the first place you want to come over here is actually through these doors right here. You're looking for the gold key. Most of the time it's in this room. Sometimes it is down here in these stairs, like on the like little seat right there. You might have to look for it. I'm going to activate the gold safe. I'm going to grab the plank. Plank's always going to be there. And then while we're in the downstairs part, we're going to run to this room and we're going to put the plank down right there. And we're going to come over here and grab the hammer. And the hammer is always in this spot. Now the hammer is used on the door right back by the gold safe where you activated that. And then the green potion is right here. So you're done with part one of the map. And this is where part two comes in. Actually, I'm going to have to go this way. Okay. Now for this next part, I'm just going to go ahead and mute myself. Just because of copyrighted music in there. I don't want the video to get, you know, like any issues. But obviously, you can keep your sound on. And then we're just going to go ahead. We're going to grab the green potion. We're going to put it right here. This is going to give us the dynamite. We're going to take the dynamite and we're going to put it in the middle just like we normally do. Just like that. There's the dynamite right there. And then for this next part, you basically complete it as normal, except the ending has a little bit of a twist. Now, this part is pretty hard. And I do want to say, if you do oof, you don't have to redo the chapter 9. Section. You can just restart this level. So if you oof, you don't have to go back and do it all over from the beginning. That's fine. We're going to grab the torch. We're going to put it in the campfire area. This is obviously going to give us the white key here or the silver key. I'm not really sure what color it is completely. And then the white key is just going to open up this safe right here or silver safe, whichever one it is. You can sometimes get the bot stuck on the end of the table. Honestly, I'm not really sure how I do it. It just randomly happens. So maybe you'll get lucky with that. Then we're going to grab the gold key that we got from the safe. We're going to put it in the vending machine. And then we're going to go and grab the other gold key, which is over here in the carnival section. So this is the second gold key you need, or the gold token, I guess. There it is right there. So we're going to grab the second gold token. We're going to put this in the vending machine, and the vending machine is going to give us a hammer. So we're going to take this hammer. Actually, I think it's a mallet, but you know, it doesn't matter. We're going to take the mallet and we're going to grab this. And this is also going to give us a Miss P photo. Now with the Miss P photo, it's very simple. You just hold it in your hand. Make sure you're holding it. Okay. And then you just run into Mr. P, and that's going to activate the ending cut. Now, whatever you do here, do not click skip. If you click skip, you have to restart, okay? Because it skips the entire ending. So do not click the skip button. All right, so after that cutscene, this is the part where you choose the good or bad ending, George or Mr. P. Now, once you have the Miss P photo, it's not going to show up on your character or anything, but you want to choose the bad ending, all right? You're going to run to Mr. P. And this is actually going to give you a little bit of a different scenario, a different cutscene than the normal bad ending. Normally, this would just give you the bad ending and you'd get infected and that would be it, like you see here. But when you actually complete the true ending, it's going to give you this right here. I'll put it up on the screen. This is from the live stream. And then that's pretty much it. You have the skin, you got Mr. P, you completed the true ending, and you're good to go. You have completed Piggy. Once you do complete it, you're not able to go back and redo it, which is why, you know, I had to put in the live stream footage here. Otherwise, it wouldn't look right. So once you get the true ending, that's it. You can't go back and reactivate it, but that is it, guys. That is the true ending. Now, of course, if you're interested in the story, I'm gonna have a video coming out tomorrow explaining what happened in the true ending and what's actually going on here. So make sure that you guys are subscribed for that. You definitely don't want to miss it. And obviously, if you do subscribe, please leave a comment down below. Let me know that you're new to the channel and that you did subscribe. And I'm gonna try to go through and heart some of your comments. Obviously, too, if you can, keep using star code Real Creek when you're buying your Robux cards or your Roblox premium. It helps out a ton. It allows me to keep buying these to give out to you guys. We give them out every day in live streams and videos. And yeah, guys, that's the true ending. After like 5 long days of streaming and trying to find this thing, we finally did it. So thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if this helped you out down below, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.